It's the 2nd of May and we're off to New Smyrna Beach. Yay! And on the way, we're going to stop off at the Cruger-dePeyster sugar mills ruins. And that should be some fun. So we'll catch you later. Bye!
Bye-bye.
Morning. It's before 8 o'clock and we've had a tiny bit of congestion a little while back, but now we're moving freely and we're going to go up I-4 and then we're going to take the Space Coast Highway over towards I-95 and the coast and then go up I-95 towards New Smyrna. Now we're leaving I-4 and we're going on to 528. Cape Canaveral, here we come! Well, we're now on the Space Coast Highway, also known as the 528 road, and it appears to have been carved out of the jungle, because on the left and the right it's just green. No sign of any buildings or anything like that, it's just deep woods. But it's a very nice road, it's a fast road, it's a smooth one, and it's getting us there super quick. It's just gone 8:30 and we're already not too far from our junction with I-95 North. And now we're on a wild woods link road. It's very small, it's very narrow, it's just the two lanes. I thought I saw some emus on the side of the road, but apparently they were vultures. I-95 going north, eventually, around the corner. It's hard to hold on. We're now on I-95. We've now entered Volusia County, and it looks pretty much the same, except on the left-hand side, there's lots and lots of trees that seem to have been burned down. Exit 244, Edgewater, and this takes us very, very near to the sugar mills, and we're almost there. Oh, this looks rather smart, doesn't it? City of Edgewater. We're turning left onto Old Mission Road. This is a very old road. Oh, it's an Indian and a horse. And this is the home of the Seminole Indians. To the sugar mill's entranceway, which is very narrow. There's not much left at all. Still some bits of equipment around. These big pots. So in the 1830s, Henry Cruger and William dePeyster built these sugar mill, and they used slaves to do all the work and the making of the sugar, because at that time basically all of the sugar industry was done by the work of slaves. But it didn't go down very well either with the slaves or with the local Seminole Indians, and in 1835, I think it was, the slaves and the Seminole Indians came together and they both decided enough was enough, and they burnt the mill to ruins. It's a very peaceful place. There's no one else about except a sheriff's car just went behind us just then, kicked up some dust. Other than that, it's just us and the birds. The walls of the sugar mills were made up from this amalgamate called coquina, and it's absolutely full of shells, and that's made it really, really strong. I don't know if you can see the pieces of shell there. Which is kind of why a lot of it is still here today. We've got a little rabbit by the side of the road. Hello, bunny. And we're going to turn right onto State Route 44. And this takes us right the way out towards the coast. Yeah, we're on parallel with Bethune Beach. We're going all the way down, but we've left behind most of the big hotels now. It's starting to get a little bit more. Oh yeah, our national park 1 mile fee required. That's the kind of thing I like to hear. It's going to get quieter. And somewhere down, in fact, just here is JB's Fish Camp. Hello. And we're going to be going there for lunch later. We're now entering Cape Canaveral State Park. And there's a $5 fee to carry on, which is fair enough.
Good morning.
Good morning, how are you?
Very good, thank you.
Another beautiful day, not quite as busy today as yesterday, so.
Well, that's good.
Fantastic, excellent. Yeah. It's $5, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Does the gentleman have a map?
I'll ask him.
Do you have a map, sir?
Yes, sir. We also have a visitor center about a mile up on the right. They've got a really good film, 17 minutes, that's a great introduction to the park. So that would be a good place to start also.
Great, thank you very much.
And here is your pass.
Oh, lovely, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Enjoy.
Thank you, bye-bye now.
Bye.
Oh, that was a nice chat.
Yeah.
Enjoy your day at the seashore. Turtle Mound. There's not many people about, and just a whole lot of sea. we've got feet in the sand. Feet in the sand. Hiya.
Hiya.
It's lovely. There's not many people here. There's a lady over there with an umbrella and a chap. And this way, there's some people quite a long way away. Other than that, we're going to have something to eat and enjoy the water. Now the clouds are building up today, but they look spectacular with the sun behind them. What a magical place. Brunch on the sand and a nice cool Sprite. It's a lovely day. And I'm braving a shark attack to dabble in the sea. Oh, it's cold. I don't know how anybody could swim in this. It's very cold. I know it's the Atlantic, but it is cold Atlantic. And all the way down there, which looks like fog, I think that's just sand being picked up. A little crab. He keeps diving into his hole. And then chucking sand over there somewhere. Oh, there he goes, he's gone. I've lost him.
Yep.
Yay! Ooh, you frightened me. And we've had our breakfast pizza, and we're just about to go and have a little look. Found some nice shells. There's not that many shells about. There's some woman, two women who were dressed almost alike. Strange women with visors. They had a Ziploc bag and they took all of my shells. And that was all I could find left, these few meager shells, because the visor ladies got them all. So there's a lesson to be learned. Bring your Ziploc bag and come down here early. Look at that cloud up there. See if you can zoom in the top. Look at that. That's magical. And that storm looks to be coming our way, I think. Got into a funny wildy backwards called Eldora Road, and I've just killed something that's left a blood stain. Ugh. Now, where are we going from here? I think it's there. There we are. Historic Eldora State House. And this is another house that cropped up, something probably in the 1800s, when they were trying to settle the area, and I think they had lots of drought and the crops all failed, and I think that was the end of the Eldora house. So this is the St. John's River. and this is the Eldora House, and we're getting eaten alive. We're going. Okay, we're at JB's Fish Camp on the St. John's River. And we've escaped all of the nasty midges. Go little fishies. Planters over there.
Hello.
What are you going to eat today?
Alligator.
How are you going to have it?
Blackened.
The far end of Atlantic Avenue, heading towards Flagler, and we're getting nearer and nearer to the Hampton Inn. It's looking a lot more beachy. South Atlantic and Flagler. Welcome to the Hampton Inn. Looks nice. Okay, we have a key card to get into our room. We are at room 127. Aha, and it works.
It's like Disney, isn't it?
Yeah. And this is our room. It is huge. And you actually have another little slot to put in the key card for electricity. Aha! And it comes on. Amazing.
Like magic.
We've just left our room and we're going to go down and have a look at Flagler Avenue. There's a warm breeze, it smells of barbecue down here, it's amazing. And we've just missed a little shower, so we're kind of lucky we're going to stay dry. Just breezy. So we're probably gonna head there, Beachside Candy, New Smyrna Beach, for fudge, ice cream, all good things. We found a place over here that's called Silly Willy's Dog and Cat Stuff.
I'm your mother.
I'm your mother.
I'm a lady, I do lady things. Hello.
It's kind of windy, but look how many people are here. Virtually nobody. We've just been into a great little place called Tada Gallery and got some nice gifts. And now we're heading to Gifts with Humanity, a fair trade store. So there's the Hampton Inn where we're staying. There's some gorgeous places around here. But right now there's only one place that I want to go, and that is to Heavenly Café for a lobster roll. Walk this way. Here we go. Heavenly Cafe, or Café Heavenly. Lobster rolls, this could be love. Check out our specials. More than a whole pound of lobster in each roll. Look at that. Lobster.
Get in my belly.
I'm not sure how to eat this, so I think let's just dive in.
Yeah. It looks as big as your head. And it'll pan away. Let you eat it. This is an amazing place, and the lady that brought it over had googled how to say lobster roll in Welsh. She did a pretty good job too, so thank you. Thank you very much.
Hoyle.
Oh, that's goodbye. Hoyle. We've just come up on a fender bender on the bridge of all places. Uh-oh. Where are they going from? Oh, they're coming from now that corner. It's going to be very loud. This is what New Smyrna Beach looks like after two lobster rolls. All along Flagler Avenue, they've got in the bricks, they've got in loving memory of people. And there's one that said that somebody had moved here in 2015. They're all over the place. It's a nice idea. Did she? Walking along Flagler Avenue. Now this sound is so different. Better. We've got the sun setting over there. Oh, and it's cold! There you go, and the sun's almost gone down.